Let's just pray together, church. Lord Jesus, we come before you tonight. Lord, we come before you humbly saying, God, we're not worthy to stand in your presence. Lord, we're not even worthy to know you. God, we don't deserve any of the things you've done for us. Any of the gifts that you've given us. Lord, thank you for life. Thank you that you're the strength in our bones. Lord, we believe that we will see your work accomplished here with our eyes. We will hear the praises of your people ring through this house with our ears. We will feel the overwhelming presence of your Holy Spirit. Satan, you have no power here. In the name of Jesus, you have no power here. Be gone. Go back to dry places. We will see his work accomplished. We will press in. We will be revived. We will be refreshed. And we won't let up until we do. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for your promise that you show up, that you come and you make the crooked places straight. I ask that you would do that tonight. Come and make the crooked places straight in our hearts, Lord. The crooked places that lie ahead of us in our life. Things that we don't understand. Situations that we don't have answers for. I ask that you would come and make those crooked places straight. I just ask that your Holy Spirit would fall in this room in a way that it never has before. Yes, Jesus. We know you're going to do something special here tonight. We don't know how. But we've just seen so much pushback from the enemy. You are in charge here. You are a king. You command this army. Thank you, King Jesus. Thank you for your love. Thank you for the blessing of your presence. Thank you for the blessing of being in this house with your people, Lord, that we can just hear, Lord, your praises being raised up to you, that we can be part of that, God. It's an honor. It's a privilege to be a part of this, to be a part of this choir. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. I searched the world, but it couldn't fail me. A man's empty praise, treasures of faith are never enough. Then you came along and you put me back together. Thank you, Jesus. And every desire is now satisfied here in your love. Oh, you church. Give him praise. Thank you. says, let faith rise up. Let faith rise up tonight. Lord, we just ask that faith would rise up tonight.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power. There is power in the name of Jesus to break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. Well, there is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus to break every chain, break every chain, break every chain,
to break every chain,
to break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
Come on, church, let's go.
There is power in the name of Jesus. Come on. There is. There's an army rising up.
Come on.
There's an army rising up.
All across the land.
To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. There's an army rising up.
Enemy has come at us strong in this church. And I'm going to tell you, I believe it's because we're on the edge of a breakthrough. I think we're on the edge of something major here. The enemy ain't happy about it. He's not cool with it. He's not going to let it slide.
My voice to worship. and I lift my voice to worship you, oh my soul. Rejoice, take joy, my King, in what
Isn't he good?
Isn't he beautiful? Isn't he lovely? So worthy of our praise. So worthy of our adoration. And I think so many times, so many other things take our attention, even within the four walls of the church.
Break through, no mountain you can move, all things are possible.
is going to send revival here tonight. That he'll start with our hearts, and that it's going to spread a fire. Lord Jesus, we just ask, Father, move in this place, move in our hearts, move in this town. She got stepped on, probably bruised.
overcome.
Yes.
You have already won. There is victory in your name. We stand on your victory now.
Thank you. would say tonight that I'm, some would say I don't like it when it rains. I don't like to get wet. And I'm not really sure what it means when I'm asking God to let it rain on me, for the Holy Spirit to come on me. Because I've experienced His power at times in my life. But we're praying, we're singing to let it really rain and pour down on us. If you really mean that, sing it in prayer. Sing it in a sincere, heartfelt prayer. God, soak me. Drench me. If it makes me uncomfortable, then so be it. If it takes me out of my natural comfort zone, then Lord, I want to get out of my natural comfort zone. I want to be filled with Your Spirit. And as we continue to sing that, sing it and really sing it. Ask Him to pour out His Spirit on you and say, Lord, whatever it takes me, whatever You lead me to do, then I'm open. I'm going to pour myself out. I'm asking You to pour out Your Spirit. I'm going to pour myself out and let go of myself and let You have me. It means giving yourself up. If You want Him to lead you, I want Him to lead me. I want Him to take me. I want Him to have my life. It says it's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God. It's a scary thought. God is going to lead us and do things in us that we otherwise would not do. But God wants to do that in us. He wants to use every one of us in here. But I have to let go and be willing to let Him do what He can, only He can do.
Open the flood.
just want us to open the altars for prayer. Maybe we don't stay there very long, but I just want it to be open right now. If we could have ushers and whoever else just come up and pray. I just feel like there are people here who want a touch from the Lord right now. And you may be sitting back saying, okay, maybe I'll just sit back here. He says, come. Come draw from the well. It is deep, but the water is rich. And when you drink from this well, you'll never thirst again. That's what he says. Are you thirsty tonight? In all of our trials and all the things we go through, there's one question. Do we want him? Sure, we want healing. Sure, we want a happy life. Sure, we want happy finances. Sure, we want a nice house. Sure. But do we want him? That's what he says tonight. If you're running from him, this is the time. This is the place. He is pouring it out. He says he will pour it out. He will not withhold.
Thank you.
alive.
So come alive in the name of Jesus. Come alive in the name of Jesus. This is a house of miracles. We bring everything to the feet of Jesus. Everything in the name of Jesus. This is a house of miracles. Oh, we say, come alive in the name of Jesus. Come alive in the name of Jesus. This is a house of miracles. And we bring everything to the feet of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, this is the house.
Church, I don't know what to say. I think we could go on probably for a while here. Isn't the Lord good? Oh, man. I don't know. I told a few of you guys. I just came off the road. Poor Pastor Vic, too. He was trying hard, and he missed his connecting flight this morning, and he's stuck in Houston. He's so bummed out. He told me he was so bummed out he wanted to be here. I just drove in from Atlanta myself. And man, life can be so distracting. But that scripture, I read it this morning. I was with some people that I work with, and we were driving in from Atlanta. And I love to check the scripture of the day and then read that whole chapter. But I just read this, and it just hits home right now. There's so much darkness in the world. There's so much sorrow. There's so much pain in the world. Where do you take it? He's asking you tonight. Just take it to him. It's that simple. Just take it to him. Don't try and fix it on your own. And I'm going to tell you guys, I was in the van today for like maybe 12 hours. My head is swimming tonight. But there's nothing like being in his presence. Man, there's just nothing like this. There's nothing like this. And it's worth it all day long, and I'll drive up 1,000 miles to get to this. Isn't he good? Y'all just give him praise, because he is good. Give him praise. Thank you, Jesus. You are good. We have one more song. It's a song of celebration. Okay. I was supposed to say that the kids are dismissed, but I think we're maybe about 45 minutes past that.
Yeah.
for this church body. I thank you for this family. God, I ask that through these fiery trials that you would strengthen us, Lord. Strengthen us like metal that's been heated in a fire that's stronger because of it. Burn out the impurities in us, God. Let us smile when we see these trials, because we know that you're at work despite the enemy. Amen? Come on. He is good. Y'all, let's just give him one last round of applause for the King of Kings. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Y'all, I'm so sorry we went over. I enjoyed every minute of it, I will say that.